Hello, it's Patrick here from the GarageBandGuide.com. When it comes to stock reverb plugins in GarageBand for Mac, we really are spoiled for choice. If you include the global and pedalboard options, there are close to a dozen different ways for you to add different types of reverb to your tracks. For my money though, the Space Designer is the most interesting and usable of GarageBand's stock reverb plugins. Here's how it works. Like most of the plugins I've covered in this series, GarageBand's Space Designer is a stripped back version of the all singing and all dancing plugin found in Logic Pro 10. There's a lot more customization options available in the Logic version, as you would expect, as well as a great looking and easy to navigate GUI. In GarageBand, we don't get the pretty graphical interface or most of the editing options. The bad news here is that you won't be able to build your desired reverb from scratch. The good news though is that every single preset from the Logic Pro version has made its way across to the GarageBand version. That includes the fantastic and processor melting HD surround reverb presets, which are admittedly slightly hamstrung without Logic's surround sound padding utility. Yeah, cheers for that, Apple. So what customization options are available? Well, first off, you'll need to select a preset and then adjust that preset's character, if you will, with the controls available to you. If I dive right in and select this Hangar 1 preset from the Large Spaces Indoor Spaces menu, I can adjust the sound with these three sliders. The length slider changes the duration that the reverb effect will last for. This can result in a hard cutoff of your reverb effect if you dial it in too short, so be aware of that. This slider doesn't affect the character of your chosen reverb preset as such, just how long the reverb will last for, so bear that in mind. The dry output slider dictates how much of your dry, unaffected signal will be present. 0 dB is the max dry output. And mute is the lowest. With mute selected, the only audio you'll hear is the affected reverb sound. And reverb output controls how much of the affected reverb signal will be heard. 0.0 decibels is again the highest, though I'd refrain from cranking the reverb output up to that level, as it will likely cause crackling and clipping. If all you want to have outputted is the reverb, then turn the dry output down and adjust the reverb output for volume. So here are a couple of examples of raw Sound Designer presets, and then how they sound once edited a little bit with the available controls. Thank you. So there you have it. That's GarageBand's Space Designer plugin all wrapped up. If you're just getting started with GarageBand on Mac or just want a refresh on the basics, you can grab my quick start guide absolutely free. I'll put a link to that down in the description box below. Which of GarageBand's plugins would you like to see me cover next? Leave a comment below and let me know. I've been Patrick from thegaragebandguide.com, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.